Hank American Engine here. This is my Season 12 review. I was inspired by the Unlucky Tugs Season 14 review, which I thought was very good. I thought maybe I could do something about maybe Season 12. I've looked around, and there are other seasons being reviewed except for Season 12. So I'm going to give my viewpoint, and then I want you to tell me your top 5 favorite episodes and tell me why. So here we go. The faces definitely needed a lot of work. Another one of those Thomas Does episodes, and we don't see any crews or anything. So it's just like the magical track switch from the Protect Cow. The crash was unrealistic. I'm pretty sure they just used a string to throw it. I wouldn't watch it again.
Steady Eddie.
We have the return of two characters, even though it's just a cameo, but my most favorite one, pulling the LMS tank engine. It was nice to see Oliver. His face was very good in CGI, and I hope they bring him back, along with everyone else.
Rosie's Carnival Special.
Coffee beans as coconuts. I need to go to Dun Brothers or Starbucks. Anyway, kind of a little perky pink Rosie being seen here, the cute little innocent one. Stephanie's return, even if it's just a cameo in the phrase, "Oh my," doesn't match his lips, but Rosie's CG face looks a lot better than her model face, so it was nice to see them again. You know, seems kind of unrealistic that would happen, because the car probably would be smashed to bits.
Mountain Marvel.
I've kind of lost my liking of the narrow gauge engines since Michael Brandon came. Not that he's a bad narrator, but I think it's just not giving him the right personalities, because they gave Ringo Starr, Michael Angelis, and George Carlin the personalities. They gave him a good voice. So, I don't really know if you should watch this one again.
Henry Gets It Wrong.
When I was watching this, I started thinking of Henry's Forest, because in the beginning of the episode of Henry's Forest, he's stopping to admire the trees, you know, and then here he was stopping to see a tree. So this sort of seems like a Henry's Forest revisit, except with a couple of lumberjacks and CG faces and whatnot, and new characters, and Salty. It also brought back Harold. Henry's Forest, because he's trying to find a way to put something he knows would be to good use, but he doesn't want to lose it. So, kind of that tree-hugging engine in the episode that Reverend W. Audrey didn't like, but the eyes for Henry needed a little work, make him look Asian. But I really liked this episode, so I would watch it again and again. Another thing, the lumberjacks, the two big ones, their faces are the exact same. Mr. Percival is the dock manager. Salty's face needs a little work.
Heave ho, Thomas.
I'm sure you all know that's my favorite episode. I think it could have used a different cast. They needed to fix the lorry or the truck next to Hank because it's really out of proportion, I think. I think they could have used probably another engine instead of Thomas. I'm thinking someone a lot older or something. Maybe like Duck, who is powerful and could probably pull the entire train, but something bad could happen, I don't know. Maybe his side rods snap off, and then Hank has to push the train for him, and push Duck to the repair yard. But he's kind enough to take Duck to the party. Then, something like that. So I would watch this again, and someone could cast a character, which we get to see from him.
Toby's special surprise.
The only upside for me was seeing Whiff. I wear glasses, and my mom has christened me Whiff whenever I smell really bad, so it was nice to see him watch it.
Excellent Emerald.
A few reasons to watch the episode. One of them is the return of Duck, whose face seems a little bit smaller than usual, I'm not so sure. But not for Bulgy, because we see Bulgy's background sitting a lot. So, one crew member instead of two, that's not very smart. And then the track sinks. One would think that the track would have just sunk all the way down and she would be, one would be at her smoke box or something like that. You know, it's just one of those things. The other reason, of course, was to see Murdoch, whose CG face looks like his mono face. So his is kind of like Oliver's, and like Hank's, because Hank's looks just like his CG face. His mono face looks like his CG face, and vice versa, and whatnot.
The party surprise.
Here, with this scene, we get to see Freddy's CG face and also Colin's model face, but only a portion of it. I guess Freddy's the only narrow gauge engine, the new one that I've taken a liking to, in addition to Mighty, because Mighty's got that little tuft of hair and makes it look like he's a bodybuilder, and then Fearless Freddy's just got the complicated side rods, which is something I have a lot, very party liking them for steam engines. I don't exactly know what to say about this episode.
Saved you.
Four reasons to watch this. Two coming up, which would be Duck and Rocky. I mean, Duck's, it's great to see Duck again, but I know this is gonna sound wrong, but he looks kinda cute when he's upset, and then when he's mad, he's just like really. Wow, he's got this fart face and Rocky's just like, I don't know what to do. So Duck's just got this fart face on. Who's funny. Him looking sad was really cute. I thought it was nice. Because he's trying to get some work done. The good old-fashioned big mastermind. If you can't tell by the music cue, this is the other reason to watch the episode. It's not Harvey, but the next two engines that come up. Everyone's favorite pair with a good name. It's Donald and Douglas. Their faces look very accurate. I hope they return to the series very, very soon. It would be very nice. I'd watch it. Duncan and the Hot Air Balloon. As stated earlier with the, party surprise, I've really lost my liking for the narrow gauge engines, so I don't know what to say about this. I probably wouldn't watch it again. It's kind of boring.
James works it out.
Again, another good episode for the Splendid Red Engine. We get to see the second reappearance of Hector with a CG face, which is very nice. Because it's rather accurate, but I think they could have done the shading a little bit better on it. Because their faces are completely lit up, and the episode seems to be kind of dark. It was nice to see James. Again, like the Unlucky Tug said, James is a good... The Unlucky Tug 02 said, James is a good character, and it's no wonder he gets good episodes. Thomas and Jane's face could have used a lot of work. Stanley's was on the ball with Hector's, but hopefully we'll see the return of Hector soon. I really liked this episode. We got to see Edward in it. There was a good cast of characters, I personally think. And I would watch it again. It's a very, very good episode.
Ram Trouble.
Okay. I don't really think Flora had to be added in. It's just kind of stupid. But it seems that a lot of people like her, and I just think it's more of a money-making thing. I never liked Flora. Thomas blushes at Flora. No. Emily, Molly, or Rosie? Sure, but not Flora.
Don't go back.
Cross-eyed Diesel. Priceless. Just funny, priceless. I also hate Michael Brandon's voice for Diesel because it's so gruff. It's like he's an evil villain. When George Carlin's was oily and smooth, the way that Diesel was supposed to sound. I hope we get to hear that again. Hopefully they'll find the appropriate voice actor for Diesel. Because Diesel is devious. Diesel is oily. Diesel is not gruff. So, definitely needed more characters.
Gordon takes a shortcut.
The reappearance of Duck for the third time in season 12. It was nice to see Duck being brought in more, and the second appearance of Oliver in the first one of Toad. I was ecstatic when Oliver and Duck returned to the series along with Donald Douglas. Oliver has been my favorite engine since I can remember. He's also a good character, so.
The Man in the Hills.
I guess the only bonus side to me for this episode was just seeing Dusty Miller. I have to say Dusty Miller has gotten very, very old. I mean, just look, he's got a mustache. His model counterpart never had a mustache, so it was nice to see two humans.
Thomas puts the brakes on.
As said in Don't Go Back, Cross-Eyed Thomas, priceless. Just funny. This had a lot of goofs, so I don't really think it would have done well. Rocky was nice to be seen, and it was nice to see Murdoch again, even if it was for a cameo. This is the second time we see him in the series.
Percy and the Bandstand.
I think they could have used maybe like two more members of the pack, like Kelly and Isabella. Isabella bringing the supplies for the thing, Kelly raising it. Jenny Packer lost weight. I have to say that she used to be heavy set, like fat, so I mean, her top hat. But she lost weight, so it was an okay episode.
Push me, pull you.
I personally believe it's highly unlikely that the children have never seen a puppet show. No. They also could have done a lot of work on Mrs. Percival. Her model counterpart looked a lot better. But, you know.
Best friend.
The reappearance of Duck with a very long freight train that seems very great question that he could probably pull. Duck's face is a lot smaller, so he still looks cute when he's sad. I guess that's kind of an upside for me, but I'm not so sure I'd watch this episode again. The whistling for them is just annoying, so. If that's it. Well, that's my season 12 review. You don't have to like it, you can agree with it and whatnot, but if you want me to review any other seasons, like the ones where they just use straight models, go ahead and let me know, because I've seen those for years, and I've loved them. Bye.